are making its intentions very clear as far as the territory of Pakistan occupied Kashmir is concerned. With effect from today, DD News and All India Radio are expected to telecast and broadcast temperatures and weather reports of Indian towns and cities including Mirpur, Muzaffarabad and Gilgit in their primetime news bulletins. In fact, DD News will be broadcasting this in their bulletins at 8:55 a.m. in the morning and 8:55 p.m. In their evening broadcast. Private channels will also be showing weather report from these cities which are at the moment under Pakistan's occupation but are legitimate Indian towns. So India making its intention very clear to Pakistan. Let's go across to senior editor Pradeep Datta, who's joining me for more inputs on the story. Pradeep, you know, this really sends out a strong message that to Pakistan, that even though the territory may be under your occupation right now, it is very much India's territory, which will in fact have a mention now in our primetime bulletins.
Yes, this is a very strong message, not only being sent to Pakistan, but also to the world community, that Pakistan-occupied Kashmir is basically part of Jammu and Kashmir that has been illegally occupied by Pakistan. In fact, in 1994, in this regard, a resolution was passed in Parliament. That time it was discussed that the POK is part of India, in fact, and we have to get it back. And we have seen that during the last few months, first it was Defence Minister, then it was Home Minister in the Parliament, full of house. He had made it clear that only disputed territory that remains right now is POK, and India has to get that back. And we have seen that Pakistan had been quite capital ever since India started making effort in this regard. And at the time when Pakistan is trying to wake up Kashmir issue at international fora, India sent a very strong message by deciding to telecast, in fact, the weather of all the major cities, which includes Muzaffarabad and Gilgit and Baltistan, because these are the part of Pakistan-occupied Kashmir right now under legal occupation of India. So message is being sent clear, loud and clear to everyone that these are part of Jammu and Kashmir. So stop, in fact, raking up the issue of Kashmir, because only disputed territory that right now remains, and that is under illegal occupation of Pakistan, and that India has to get it back. Already in this case, we have seen that the Pakistan Prime Minister was nettled to an extent that 2 months back in full of assembly, he had also expressed concern in Muzaffarabad that India is making attempts in this regard. We have already seen the people from Gilgit, Baltistan, as well as Mirpur. They had come out in protest and they had also expressed their happiness that finally India is taking up their issue at a stronger level, because earlier they thought it was after 1994. The things were not moving in this direction. But now India has been openly coming out and talking about this issue. And now a very big statement where the weather report of these regions will also be in fact telecast and broadcast. So message is clear for each one of them to understand. At the time, this has, and in fact a message has come at the time, but 2 days back we saw that there was a citation from Pulitzer body where they tried to say that it was Jammu and Kashmir was a contested land. So it is also a message for the lobby as well as certain organizations who are working overtime to malign image of country and rake up Kashmir issue directly or indirectly. This message is clear for them also, that only area that remains disputed, contested, and what India has to get back is Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. The issue is not about Jammu and Kashmir. Everybody knows it is an integral part of India. So anything that is new, what India has to get back is Pakistan-occupied Kashmir right now under illegal occupation of Pakistan. Already we have seen several protests had been in this region where the people had been coming out and raising slogan, ye jo dehshatgardi hai, iske piche wardi hai. They say that how Pakistan army has been committing atrocities against them. The people in this region are suffering. And so they are looking towards India so that India should come to their aid. So unlike Pakistan, India has never ever tried to support any kind of terror-related activity or what actually the Pakistan had been doing in this part of Jammu and Kashmir. But yes, morally, it is a very strong support that has been extended by India. It will be a sigh of relief for the people who have been looking towards India, that at least India should do something for them so that they can also come out of the clutches of the Pakistan army that had been committing human rights violations for the last so many years, because they are the ones who had been suffering. Recently, in fact, the Public Service Commission in Muzaffarabad was formed in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. And there also, the chairman was the retired army officer. So it is basically army that's calling shot. Hardly there is any power given to the civilian government. So though they call it Azad Kashmir, but there is hardly anything Azadi for the people of that area, that is something. So that way, it's a very important, significant, and a strong
message. Essentially, Pradeep, like you are pointing out, this is a message from the Indian government, Indian side, and it is going to be delivered at multiple levels. One is that we have not given up on our people who happen to be under Pakistan's occupation in POK. Those people who are staying in towns of Mirpur, Muzaffarabad, and Gilgit in POK are also our own people, because this is a wholesome territory of Jammu and Kashmir. And secondly, Pakistan is reminded through this message that you are the illegal occupier, and we are just expanding the scope to include all parts of the territory of Jammu and Kashmir.
Yes, you're rightly saying in fact a reminder to Pakistan that it is basically Pakistan that has illegally occupied these areas. And if you look at the situation during the last 2.5 years, there had been several protests in Pakistan occupied Kashmir where people had come out and they had been protesting against the Pakistan government as well as against the army, because they feel that they are something because of them. No democratic rights are being extended to them, neither they are allowed to have a freedom of speech the way people are enjoying in Jammu and Kashmir in a democratic country like India. But Pakistan deliberately...